Look at the size of this ship, holy shit. Hey guys, this is Anamite and welcome back to Tropico 6, ladies and gentlemen. Now you probably wondering what the hell is happening over here. Is this some type of mission? Is this some type of scenario? Is this multiplayer? Is this a challenge? Is this whatever? No! You probably read the title that we're gonna try to actually get into the modern era for the first time on the channel in Tropico 6. Now, ladies and gentlemen, first things that we need to put on the table first. Basically, this is the city that I have built during the streams. If you are following the channel, you know that I'm streaming twice a week, at least I try. So far, I've managed to maintain that thing. And yeah, we were actually building an actual city in Tropico 6 during those streams. This has been done on the random map generator. This entire island has been generated by the game randomly. That's the first thing. The second thing, you probably noticed that I have 2,000 people living over here. So if you're gonna see freezes, it's because it's a lot of people here. It's an improvement since the beta version, because if you remember, I think in the beta we had like 1,200 people, and basically that was the thing. The game died back then. Now we are maintaining 2,000 people, and the game, let's put it this way, runs technically smoothly, right? That's like the thing, because if you have like, if you're like actually wondering how many people you can have in this game, there's actually a slider in the gameplay option, and as you can see, you can have up to 10,000 people over here. Though I doubt that I actually have enough people, I mean enough of a hardware to maintain this type of population. So I'm gonna try to stick to, let's say, 3,000, and hopefully my rig won't explode, ladies and gentlemen, so just so you know. So before we're gonna progress to the modern era, let me show you around, ladies and gentlemen. So basically, this is the overview of the random generated map. It's really beautiful. I'm really happy with this random generation. It actually allowed me to do some really fancy stuff up here. As you have noticed, this is my palace. My palace is situated on this little cliffside over here. There's a bunch of slums over here because of the mine, which of course they will disappear as soon as the mine will like harvest all of the necessary resources. So the presidential palace with a small garden and two embassies. Then you have the tunnel over here, and as I said, the game is freezing like crazy. The tunnel that is the only access to the presidential palace, next to a military base, and then of course the highway. Over here we have a small jewelry factory thingy. Then we have a little bit of slums over here, another mines. Then we have the more rich citizens part of the city, let's put it this way. So basically this is where the rich people live. I don't ask me how the heck I've managed to get super fancy residents and then next to them some shacks. Yeah, that's something. I didn't say the city is finished, right? I didn't say the city is actually done. Now this is an actual downtown. As you can see, a bunch of banks. I was trying to mimic the thingy from the beta version that basically allowed you to make money out of thin air. Can't say this is exactly working as it was working. Maybe it's still a valid option. For now, it's not working. Then we have still the highway continuing over here. The highway goes over here around. And at the moment, I'm trying to build a very fancy, well, how to put it, tourist area? I think this is the proper word. So yeah, we're gonna try to get some actual tourists over here. Just before I'm gonna try to do, I need to remember to put a bus station. And actually, well, let's be honest over here. Nobody who's gonna come to this island, that's a tourist, actually wants to see poor shacks located next to the hotel. So that's like the thing I need to fix immediately. So allow me to do so very quick. As such, I place the bus stop right over here, and I hope that the shacks will now disappear. I honestly hope that this is the thing and they will disappear. If not, then we have to make some type of apartments over here and other type of infrastructure for the citizens. Now carry on. The highway currently ends over here. We have a bunch of mines over here. Then it continues over here, and we have a lovely nuclear program right over here, ladies and gentlemen, where the thing is currently progressing, because we want to develop the bomb and we're gonna blow up something, probably not. Then we have the factory area over here, the industrial part of the island. basically a bunch of factories, a port, a garrison commando, and, well, a bunch of apartments just for the people to have a place to live. Once again, a small highway that goes up here next to a power generator and, of course, a fancy nuclear power plant next to soon to be, hopefully, a fully operational military base that will protect the bay where the ships will arrive to export and import goods.
The power to bring the world to an end is at your fingertips, as it always should have been.
Of course, make Tropico great again, ladies and gentlemen, because we are progressing to modern times. We have forever put Tropico under the maps of the Tin Pot Caribbean Islands chain that somehow managed to acquire its own nuclear capability. They said it couldn't be done. And even those that didn't say that said it should be done. But we did it anyway.
Presidente, the Cold War is over. The future is now present, and the present will presently pass into the past.
What an amazing things to be have, like airports, shopping malls, and something called internet that allows people to complain about television more quickly. A new age of wonders begins. But the constant pressure coming from the eight factions play the diplomatic game with five superpowers trying to exploit Tropico, use hackers to fake tourist ratings or tweak trade routes conditions. Tell me more. Oh my god, look at all of this thing. Interesting. Alright, so now we're dealing with China, I guess? Hold on a second, what's new? Explore the full range of building upgrades, modernize residential and production buildings, optimize traffic with new transport options, explore ecology-friendly alternatives to pollution-heavy industries and power sources. China.
Ah, and you are the Tropican Presidente. How exciting. I, Ambassador Zhang, am now your political conduit to China and its immense power. I am one of many thousand officials tasked with securing shares in other countries. Tropico is not in the top 100 on our list, but I am in the bottom percentile of Chinese ambassadors. It is good to meet you.
Hi man, how are you? For the thousands of years, Presidente, China has dedicated itself to master of war. Now it seems that we must fight economically. Cheap labor allows us to dominate in trade, and our reserves of capital help us to buy what we want. The United States of America, for example. Oh, okay, great. Ultimately, however, this is a simple defense. What we do not do, someone else will. Russia.
Some people make laws. Some follow them. Imagine if the people who make laws were also required to abide by those laws. Foolishness. They would simply make laws to benefit themselves, would they not? For some to be above the law, like myself, Vlad Orlov, and like you, El Presidente, this is our only hope for justice.
Obviously, this is Vladimir Putin. Haha, global politics, Presidente. The biggest ever game in which everybody wants to something different before they can say they have won. Or, of course, we all want oil. We want economic strength. We care about our people, or at least require to spend some time pretending that this is so. But to be a Russian, you have to learn to take whatever it is you need to survive. The United States!
Make this quick, I've got a talk show in an hour. Everyone's hungry for a slice of Raymond King, Presidente. Politics, media, real estate, I do them all. I got money in trains, towers, guns, and long, thin cruise liners. I'm a Renaissance man. Everyone wants to be my friend, Presidente, so it's no surprise to me that you do too. Well, we'll see. We'll see.
I'm guessing this guy is supposed to be Trump. You think I want to be your friend? No, 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 my dear. You will beg me to be your friend. You want to talk about America? Well, I got red, white, and blue blood, so you come to the right place. What do we want? Hey, Thomas, we already got it. We're the best. The best in the whole dang world. So now, I'd like to keep it. If that's okay with you, or even if it's not. If I am gonna be honest. Okay, Middle East.
It is good to meet you, Presidente. I am Prince Thari. I was the world's richest toddler, you know, and the world's richest child. Then I was the world's richest teenager. So embarrassing. Now I am a man, but I am unable to put away childish things. Tell me, do you ever feel melancholy?
So you have been the richest child, the richest toddler, and the richest teenager, but apparently you're not the richest man. And I'm guessing you're gonna give me a lot of problems. Can you imagine how that feels to me, Presidente? My country owns large amount of the most important resources in the world. You need bitcoins? Or you need V-Bucks from Fortnite? I control transport, electricity, and plastic, so I'm a very easy to be friends with. Because you all need just what I have. I'm generous, because I can afford to be. And like my friends to be generous in return. Dude, I'm just gonna take whatever I want, and I don't really care.
Finally we meet. I'm Aline Dupont, Presidente. I had a few minutes between quangos, so I filled in this lovely form explaining who I am. Now, some people resent the European Union's meticulousness. Indeed, some people prefer to cut corners. But if you cut one corner, you make two more. Fixing cut corners is what the red tape's for, Presidente.
Interesting. Are you supposed to be Merkel? Oh, great. You even have a similar face, though you look a bit like a French. I don't know why. Considering sheer size of the other world powers is clearly essential for Europe to put together. We need to be economic force, you see. Labor is cheap elsewhere and the world gets even smaller. But without trade, we are meaningless. But to pull together is not so easy when we have spent hundreds of years fighting each other. So, we have established many rules. Yeah, most of them stupid, but hey, what do I know, right?
I'll be with you in a minute, Presidente. I'm just kidding.
Okay, so those are the guys that we already know. Do you know why I love and then we have the two new fractions.
One moment, please. I'm in the middle of a scientific breakthrough. Or is it a breakdown? Sorry, I'm going nuts. I must have jammed too many thoughts in my brain today. I am the smartest person in the room. Presidente! Dr. Elena Culpepper. Need some super broccoli, non-tangle wiring, self-basting turkey? You just let me know.
I need guns, weapons, and missiles if you can actually give me it. Thank you. Open-minded globalists who challenge the old ways of thinking and doing things. They like progress, building with new technologies and governmental tools that improve conditions of the people and the environment with the vision of peace, global society. Okay, so I'm guessing you are like the intellectualists from the previous games. Dislikes old-fashioned, religious and military traditions. Okay, and conservatives.
I bet you're here to ask how to make the world a better place, hey, Presidente? But that's a trick question. The world already is a better place, and these fancy, weak-minded, liberal ideas are just making things worse. Trust all Hector Delgado. The best way to ruin an omelet is to try to fix eggs that were never broken in the first place.
Interesting. They want to preserve the founding principles of the Tropican state, resisting changes and the influence of modern progressive ideologies. They like tradition, both in terms of building and governmental tools. They gladly sacrifice personal liberties for security, defense, and keeping the country free from non-Tropican influencers. Oh! Okay, I actually liked this faction back in Tropical 4. I think they were like a big support to me. Okay. Oh my god. Okay, healthcare. Clinics and hospitals determine the required economic wealth and service free individually. Their effectiveness is increased by 20%. Clinics and hospitals serve citizens of all economic wealth levels and take no fee. Their effectiveness is increased by 2%. Hybrid system. Clinics and hospitals serve citizens of all economic wealth levels. Citizens that are poor or broke do not pay the fee, but in turn only receive 75% of healthcare happiness from visiting them. Okay, let's go with this one. Surveillance, personal rights. As long as there is a working ministry of information, all laws and role change are registered. Decreases the global liberty by 25, increases the global crime safety by 5. Security surveillance, police stations and religious buildings in the theocracy check all residents and workers in the crime safety radius and detect hidden roles with a 5% probability. Increases the global liberty by 5. Prophecy writes, security checkpoints are prohibited from discovering hidden roles. Increases the global liberty by 5. Okay, let's go with this one, I guess. Right! So, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the modern era. And boy, We're gonna have a lot of fun. Look at the size of this ship. Holy shit. Okay, elections are coming and I'm about to lose this thing, so we have to do something to prevent that thing from happening. Obviously, okay, those buildings have changed. Okay, we have more sharks, which is kind of like annoying. Okay, can I get like new types of buildings here that actually can house more people? I don't think so. Well off or better. Okay, so question is, does the people who live here, are you... Okay, you're actually rich. That's interesting. Okay, so I think we could try to do some changes around in this district and actually hopefully put more people over here. So, 16 you say? Okay, that's like a bunch of people that could try to live here. Oh, yes. Very fancy apartments. Very nice indeed. Okay, so let's get rid of some of those. And we're gonna try to do some, well, improvements around in Tropico, of course, because it's now all about improvements and, well, increasing the quality of life of Tropicans, that is. Now, get rid of this one as well. Right, modern apartments, please. I can actually squeeze them here. Oh, it's so beautiful. Oh, this is gonna be great. I just can't wait for this thing to actually finish the proper way. Now, okay, I'll actually destroy those things as well. Oh yes, we're gonna have a lot of improvements over here, then. This is gonna be glorious. It's gonna be truly, truly glorious. I just don't know how to put this building around. Okay, let's try to put it like this, maybe. Can I put like actual gardens around you? Technically I can, which is great. Okay, there you go. Right, remember to put more houses in front of this. Very, very nice. Beautiful. Beautiful that is. Okay, remember to put some decorations here as well. Because reasons. There you go. Right. Okay, looks like we have to put actually more houses as well. Maybe I should actually consider to put a connection to this part of the city with a different part of the city. It's of influence trouble. Yeah, like that's the thing. We have to get ourselves some more. Oh my god, look at all of those funks. Hang gliding, Museum of Modern Art, Yacht Club. All of those new fancy buildings. Oh my freaking god. Waste treatment facility, shopping malls, asylum, that's actually the old thing. Defense HQ, Drone Command, Cyber Operation Center. Ministry of Information, Blimp Police Office, generates profit based on the number of all employed workers across Tropico, offshore office. All of this thing for us to use today. And boy oh boy, we have a lot of improvements over here to be done. Oh my god, can I improve this thing? Needs upgrade electrification. Ah, so I first have to buy this thing before I can upgrade all of my other apartments. Okay, that's interesting. So, apparently we first have to solve the problem with electricity, which is like a thing. So, what new types of electricity we have? We have, of course, my favorite from Tropico 4. The wind turbine supplies a small amount of electrical power. Provides an electrical power grid. Decreases housing quality of surrounding residential buildings. Obviously, solar power plant supplies electricity power. Provides an electrical grid. So, this thing is good because it actually does not require working force. And if I remember correctly, the higher you put this thing, the more electricity it provides. Though apparently this thing is no longer like an important factor, so that's good to know. Okay, we could try to put you somewhere around. Too bad I cannot put you on the cliffs. Because that'll be like actually really fancy. Okay, like this is a good spot, I guess. So let's place like two over here and then like build another over here and see how it's gonna go, ladies and gentlemen. Actually, let's try this one because you're standing on the sand and that's something I would love to avoid. Question is, if you're gonna put those things within range of one another...
By astonishing coincidence, the vote tallies match those Canal Uno was given last night. An astounding result for El Presidente. Congratulations.
Well, of course, I kind of like wonder just putting them in close vicinity. Do they reduce the amount of electricity that they make? Like, is this a city skylines type of thing? Or is it just like old tropical style? Okay, let's put one more over here and see. Will I get more or less electricity? This one provides me plus 29. Okay, so apparently 19. 29. Okay, so there is some type of the higher you build it, the more electricity you get type of thing. So let's, for example, see how many electricity I'll get if I'm gonna build this thing here on the side. Just to see, just to give this thing a little bit of an experiment. And the winner is 40. Yeah, just as I thought. So the higher you put those things, the more electricity you get. Interesting. Now, this thing, the solar power plant, does not require any type of fuel and just works around the clock. And this is exactly the thing we need. Right, time to get rid of the uranium thingy because it's expensive to maintain. It's expensive to get fuel. So get rid of it because, ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna get better electricity. How many this thing is make? This is providing me with 750 electricity. And let's see how much electricity I will get from the solars. How much power I will get. Will I get enough power to build myself a... This thing is big. Okay, that's interesting. Will I get enough power to actually build myself a interplanetary laser beam to destroy my opponents? Okay, let's see. Quick build. Alright, how much power you can provide? How much power you can actually provide? Okay, we have to move all of this thing around the corner. Just so you know, metro station also have been needs to be moved. That's okay. No problemo. We have enough money to do this type of magic. Speaking of money, yes. Very nice. Come on, export all of this. And I've made 38,000. Okay, well, as long as I'm above 1 million, I'm safe with that thing, right? So, metro station. Yeah, sure, build this thing here. The parking deck. Build it over here. And of course, the military base that had to be destroyed because I had to move things around a little tiny bit. So, build it over here. And it should all be nice and dandy. Just build this thing quickly. There we go. Okay, how much power do you provide? 450. Interesting. Sunny afternoon. Solar overload. Increases the power production by 25. Solar power plant deteriorates over time. Interesting. Increases the power output by 10. Okay, so that's almost 500. Without wasting a single penny on fuel. And if you're gonna increase the payment to its maximum amount, you get 619 power. Without much of a problem, so I think for now that should be more than enough. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, so time to upgrade the apartments. Every single one of them. Okay, building all of the apartments will cost me almost 20,000. Okay, I don't want to upgrade all of them, I just want to upgrade some of them.
I have something I would like you to do.
Okay, thank you. Okay, you don't have power. Can you like stop with the quest for 5 seconds? I'm trying to get my apartments to work. What is that thing? Okay, apparently I have problems with power still. How is that possible? Network balance, minus. Okay, good to know. Much better! Look at this thing! The downtown is actually taking shape. And this is gonna be beautiful, glorious. Okay, so what are the new ways of means of getting money? Because that's like the second question I have. Waste treatment facility. Okay, so apparently you take the garbage and you turn it into something more pleasurable. Right, this is how it works. So this is pollution of other buildings within range. Okay, you have like a decent range, I'd say. Shopping mall sells edible goods to provide food to households and citizens. Okay, ooh, you're actually like quite big. I'm guessing you are the new shopping mall building, right? Do I actually have this thing over here? Yeah, I do. Okay, we could try to wreck this one and just build ourselves a new shopping mall over here and see how it's gonna go. Right? Let's see. Can I fit this thing here? Technically, I can. I just have to move the road around. Okay, the road actually won't fit over here. We have to swap the TV station somewhere around. Okay, let's destroy this thing temporarily. We're gonna build ourselves a new fancy shopping mall over here. Like such. And then I'm gonna move the TV station literally next to it. As such, okay, decorate the gardens back. So I don't know why the gardens over here are like so red. Something is very bad.
New privacy laws have.
It's because of the theater? Maybe. With respect of that, what else do we have? Okay, this is the Dimitri defenses. Asylum is not new. This is tourism. This is entertainment. Modern mansions, not exactly needed. We have new factories, that's for sure. Electrical factory process golds and plastic to produce electronics, emits pollution. Fashion company process cloth or leather to produce apparel. Okay. This thing I remembered back in the Tropical Four provide you with a bunch of money. It basically turned oil into medics. Like medicals thingies. So it was like a huge thing to get. And it actually is quite small over here. That's interesting. Juices is apparently... No, this building is still the most expensive ones to get, I guess, money. So that's actually quite nice. But still, where was the office? Ah, there it is. Okay. Offshore office. Hosts a company of one of the superpowers. Generates money at the cost of losing relations with the corresponding one superpower. Office. Generates profits based on the number of all employed workers across Tropico. Okay, so let's see. How does this thing actually works? Huh? Okay, can apparently build you whatever I want. So that's good to know. Let's try to build you maybe here. Okay, quick build. Oh, I built an office. Okay, that was a quest. So, how do you work? Increase job quality. Okay. Corporate business. The office generates $1 on base efficiency per employed citizen across Tropico. The office generates $2 on base efficiency per family living in residential buildings, except shacks. Official business. The office generates $5 based on efficiency per employee of government and financial buildings. Solid business. Ah, and then you have the fractions over here. Interesting. Okay. Right,
pleasure
so
doing business with you, President.
Let's keep it and see how much money this thing actually will make. Okay, so the office managed to work for like a little bit. Okay, so last income from last month was almost 1,000. Okay, so let's see a factory that's on this island for like since the very beginning, I guess. That was, I think, this thing, the room distillery. I haven't moved this thing, I believe, an inch. So how much money you have made? Income, lifetime. Okay, well, you're actually not making me that much. You've made in the last month 1,000. Okay, so how about we're gonna check this cigar factory. How much money you have made? You're also not making that much. I'm guessing this because I don't have that many resources around. Interesting. So the office is actually making this much money? Okay, we just need college workers. Interesting. So actually like learn a thing or two when you actually investigate the buildings, you know. So for example, the office right now is making me, well, a bunch of money. I've built another office over here and it's making like around 1,000. Based on the amount of people that are currently on my island. Interesting. Very interesting indeed. Though I don't know why it shows that this building is not making me a profit. Income. Production value. It's hard actually to determine. No, I've made money out of this thing. Because if I was not able to make money out of this thing, then now basically would lost like long time ago. But okay, apparently the weapon factory is making around. Apparently the weapon factory is making like around 3,000 cash income, and the office is making how much? Around 2,000.
Vandalism competition ended interesting in victory today for the Tropican Rebels.
I don't know why it's like something is attacking me constantly. I don't know what's the deal with that thing. Okay, and this thing is not making anything because you require steel, and you are not making anything because you require coal. All right, let's find a trade deal with coal minerals. Okay, ah, oh great, those are those guys. No, this is for export. I need to buy export. What is the import? Import call. There you go. Sign a contract with them. Okay, so we should get enough resources now to start the production of steel. Okay, what's your problem? Do you don't have gold? Yeah, apparently you don't have gold. Okay, so we have to fix that thing as well. Import gold. I want you to import me, well, maybe this many. There you go. Okay, so should we actually try to go into the new department of factories, you know, because I think they can also make me like a bunch of money. Fashion company sounds fun. So let's try maybe this one, huh? They already required power. Like, this is the biggest issue I have right now, because I'm not making enough power, so that's like the thing we need to probably fix very, very soon in this game. Okay, what I could actually try to build... Maybe I should try to build in the production district? But then again, I don't have many people over there. Like, building this thing over here would be probably like a better idea, right? Homeless citizens, unemployed citizens, 300. Yep! That's actually a very good idea, because we have apartments over here that are currently empty. And as we all know, having empty apartments, it's not exactly a good thing to have. So this factory actually takes in cloth and leather and puts out appeal. Okay, empty stock, don't say. Gives the housing quality of residential buildings within a radius of 12 grids. Sells by 5 and based on the efficiency, production is decreased by 1%. Okay. The building consumes both cloth and leather to produce appeal. Increases the wage just by 200 and the job quality by 20. Okay, not exactly sure how that's supposed to help me, but that's nice, I guess. Okay, well, I'm making a bunch of money, that's for sure. Right, the only thing... the only problem I have currently is with electricity. Is there, like, a way to increase the electricity output? Managing crisis, global market economy. I don't think... Okay, looks like I have to, like, return to a nuclear power plant at some point. Because if you're gonna keep doing, like, this thing, then I won't be able to maintain the electrical need of my people. Which is not exactly the thing I want to achieve over here. Okay. So let's maybe put this thing here. And then we have to, sadly, return back to import uranium. So that's like a thing. Okay, sign a contract with those guys and hopefully... Things will return back to normal. Also, we have to...
The future of healthcare or a billion-dollar scam for American pharmaceutical corporations?
Yeah, whatever.
But now Uno suspects you already know the answer.
So this is the thing. You have the new, let's say, farms. The best thing about this is that you don't have to put them on actual, like, ground. Fertility ground, let's put it this way. To produce certain goods. So let's say that if you're gonna go to the overlays and the crops thingy, so... Sugar, for example, will not grow over here. The hydroponic plantation does not give a two shits. You can build this thing even in the middle of the desert, and it still is gonna produce you the necessary resources, which is very fancy. So that's gonna build this thing. Then you have the automated mine. Extracts mineral resources from coal, iron, gold, nickel, aluminium, or uranium deposits at higher rate. Emits pollution. Factory ranch. Okay. Requires corn for feeding the animals. Fish for crocodiles. Emits the pollution. Does the same goes for the ranch? Does not, so this is interesting. The factory ranch actually requires some type of fuel to maintain its production, while the normal ranch does not. Interesting. Okay, so you put in core and you get out resources. Increase the efficiency of nearby plantations and hydroponic plantations by 10%. The bonus does not stack. And then you have the sugar plantation. Increase the efficiency of nearby plantations and hydroponic plantations by 10%. A cap of 20. Almost natural. Increase the consumption of electrical power by 10. Increase the efficiency by 10. So, it has its pros and cons, but then again, the efficiency here is set right off the bat on 160, which is something kind of hard to achieve. And then you have this thing, which should increase the efficiency even more, but apparently I'm not in range. And then you have this thing, which increases the efficiency even more. I kind of like wonder if I'm gonna put two of those things and send them to sugar. Will they benefit one another? Will you? Oh shit, this is corn. Okay. I need to change the resources to sugar. Okay. So I don't see the efficiency increased. It's just set on 160%, maybe because it's lacking the road and power. Is this the case? Could be. Okay, so this is something I don't understand. I've built another, like, plantation over here. It still has efficiency of 160. Those have 160, even though that this thing is technically supporting the wood efficiency. Maybe this is a bug and it's actually not working at the moment. It's hard to say. But yeah, this actually opens a bunch of new possibilities. I mean, from one side to another, it depends how you're gonna look at this thing, because technically this thing is smaller. It only hires 4 people, right? So I could make like a factory, let's say like a cigar factory, and put literally hydroponic plantations around it, and I'm gonna get like tons of resources to manufacture, let's say, cigars from it. But then again, those plantations, the old system plantations, they have the efficiency of 218, 200, 223, 218, 207, 245, 218, 232. I mean, I don't think I can get any better than that. So, is this actually like worth of the struggle to upgrade this thing? Because I have my doubts right now. Honestly, I do. Interesting. Fertility of the land is decreasing, but I don't actually think that anybody will worries about that thing. Increase efficiency by 50%. Okay. Apparently the efficiency just skyrocks, if you want or not. It just goes up and up and up and keeps going up like there's no tomorrow. Very interesting. Very, very interesting. Right, ladies and gentlemen, so I actually think this is a good moment to cut this episode over here. We've managed to achieve finally the modern era.
A rebellion, Presidente.
Oh, hello.
If these rebels want your attention so badly, they should make an appointment like everybody else.
It's actually like a rebel attack, what? Seriously? You tried to...
Anyone who suspects that an uprising is in progress is simply wrong, the palace informs us. We are told that some citizens are simply letting off steam.
Oh yeah, you're gonna let off some steam. Where are my tanks? Invite the tanks to the party, please. By all means! I think I should actually like send my tanks towards the enemy and just wreck the living shit out of them. Yeah, how many rebels actually are gonna try to attack me? Just one pack, and then one pack managed to destroy already one of my towers. That's just great. That's just wonderful. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, as I was saying, there you go, Fred done. As I was saying, I think this is actually a good moment to cut this episode over here. We've managed to get like the first impression of can I like pause this game? Okay, we get like the first impression of the modern era. We're gonna probably try to continue this thing during the next episodes. Maybe we're gonna try to actually balance this thing a little bit better. Maybe I'm gonna try to look for a different source of power, and maybe we're gonna try to rebuild the island even more and hope that my rig actually won't explode. But all of that thing actually is gonna be happening in the next episode, because as I said, I'm running out of record time. It's actually quite late already, so I'm gonna leave it as of here. So thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed. If you liked the episode, please subscribe a lot. I'll see you all in the next video.